Hi guys, and welcome to this simple CSS video. This is Jamie from System22 and GreatWebDesign.com. In this series of videos, we're just going to cover some simple CSS tweaks that you can easily make to your website. Now, what is CSS? Well, CSS stands for Cascading Style Sheets, and that's the actual information that the website pulls in, and it dictates what the actual website's going to look like. Background colors, font sizes and styles, etc. So I've got a very simple looking site here. For anybody that wants to follow along with this site, I'll make it downloadable. I'll put a download link below this video. Now, this is a little bootstrap site. If I pull this folder over here, this is all it is. It's just a few files in here. It's got an index HTML document, which is what we're looking at the moment. I'll just show you that. We open our brackets text editing software. This brackets text editing software is another free download. It's a great text editor if you don't have one. Again, you can download it from a link below this video. So this is our index HTML file, and this is the skeleton of our little site here, basically. This is just telling the browser what to render. Now, to make it a little more interesting, to add colors and sizes, it needs to have a CSS file. We've got two CSS files here. The first one here is the Bootstrap CSS, which is just dictating the default styles for the Bootstrap framework. And one that I've created here called Simple CSS. This is the one we'll be working on to add our CSS. If I go to it, it doesn't look like much. And it's just got a little bit of a padding for the body and a minimum height for our sections that we've got going on there. All of this I will cover in future lectures. In this first lecture, we're just gonna do background color change. Very simple, very easy to do. So if we go back to our browser here with our site, for anybody that didn't know, to get your site up in your browser, all you do is double click on the index HTML file and it'll bring it up in the browser. When you've got a live site online, a browser will always look for the index.html file and display it first, or index.php file. So the first file that you want on your site is usually the index file. Okay, well, let's change some background colors here. So I'm using the Chrome browser here, which again is a free download for anybody that doesn't know. And if you right click and go down to inspect, or you can hit the F12 button if you prefer, it'll bring up a panel like this. We've got our HTML on the left hand side, and we've got our CSS on the right hand side, as long as you've got that styles tab. It'll show you the CSS over here. Yours may be up the side. You can change which way around you have it. Just work with it any way that's convenient for you. So to change a background color, very easy indeed. Let's pick a section. Let's say this first section here. Again, if I just right click and inspect it, it should pick up whatever I've clicked on there. If it doesn't, you can just click between anything and it'll highlight as you're going up and down what you're actually selecting there. So we want that first section. So I've selected that, and over here it's got our CSS for that particular section. There's not much in there at the moment. Now I want to change the background color. So let's just click after this curly bracket here at the top element style and write background colon. Now we want to put in our color. Let's just select anyone from random here. A bunch have come up. You can use hexadecimal, you can use RGB, you can use just colors like this. Say beige, and you'll see it's turned it to beige there. But of course, although this has done it in the Chrome browser here, once we refresh this site, it's going to go back to how it was, and we want to keep this as permanent. But this is a fantastic way of testing out ideas and CSS before you actually put them into your style sheet. If I demonstrate and do a refresh here, See, it's just gone back to normal. So let's do that again. Now, how are we going to keep it that way? Well, what we've got to do, we've got to put this in our style sheet so that every time this site loads, it pulls in this information that tells it this section wants to have a background of beige. Now, if we look over here at our HTML, this section's got a class of first, and that's what we want. So we want to tell it first wants to have a background color of beige. So let's just copy this bit of code we've put in here. Just left clicking and selecting and Control C to copy. Then if we go back to our bracket software, go to our simple CSS file here. Let's give it a title. At the moment, there's hardly anything in this CSS file, but when you've written hundreds and hundreds of lines of code, it's often difficult to find stuff. So if you put a title in there, it makes it a little bit easier for you. So to put a title in, it's simply /**, then go back in between and give it whatever title you want. So I'll just call this first section. Now down below, we want to tell it to apply this to that first section. So if we go back to the site here, remember it was called class of first. So we need to put period or dot and then that name first. And like most coding, it's really important you spell everything correctly or things will not work. So after we put first, put a little gap there, open and close some curly brackets, give it a space in between, and we'll just paste in that code we copied from our browser just now, background beige. Just pull it back with shift tab, try and keep your code tidy, and save it, Control S. Now, if we go back to our index file, as it's pulling in from our simple CSS file every time it loads, it should be telling the first section to have a background of beige. Let's try it. So when we refresh this time, it should stay exactly the same. There we have it. It's fresh. Let's do another one quickly. Let's do the second section. Just inspect it. Give it a background color of blue. Like I say, you can use background color seems to work. It's kind of the old way of doing it, but background works just as well, or at least seems to. Let's say blue. Just copy that. Control C. Back to our style sheet. And again, we'll do a second section because these sections, we're going to put a whole load more CSS for each section here. And let's just check that name. I'm pretty sure it was just second. Yep, second. So we'll put dot. Period, second, gap, open and close some curly brackets, give it a space in between, and again paste our code in there that we copied from our browser. Like I say, this time we've used background color, just less to type, works just as well, but it's entirely up to you, both work. So let's do a quick save, back to our site. Do a quick refresh and that should stay exactly the same. There we have it. So we've effectively changed the background color of that, background color of that. May as well do this one too. Simple, same process. This time I'll just use background again. I don't even know what bisque is, but let's try bisque. Okay, it's kind of pinky. Let's just copy that one. And back to our style sheet. Again, this is repetition. Title. As we go through these, we'll be adding more to these sections, like I say, padding and margins and text decoration and box shadow and what have you. So again, this is dot third. Let's just check that the class was third. There we are, class third. So it's going to be dot third. Open and close your curly brackets for a change. Paste your copied text in there. Shift tab, or just pull it back in line with the rest of them. Yep, we've got our little colon there, semicolon. Control S to save, back to the site. Refresh, and it should say the same. So there we've had it. We've got an extremely ugly site here, color scheme wise. But anyway, that is how to change the background colors on your little sections. It works with anything. You can do it with your menu. Same thing. You can actually do it with your text as well. Same thing. So that'll do it for this first video here. If you've enjoyed this video, please subscribe to our channel. We will be doing a lot more with CSS as we go along. If you're interested in web design, please take one of our courses below. We've got them heavily discounted for our subscribers here. Once again, this has been Jamie from System22 and GreatWebDesign.com. Thanks for watching. Have a great day.